So we're going to do our literacy block now.
My name is Freya Lucas.
So first thing we're going to do is do our print walk.
I've been teaching at Tom Price Primary School for 4 years now.
Pronouns. What is a pronoun?
Tom Price is a mining town in the middle of the Pilbara. It's 1,600 kilometres from Perth, and it's a very transient community. We also have a high percentage of Aboriginal children.
And my, what type of pronoun is that?
A first person.
Well, at the start of the year, I try to establish a community within the class. Routines every day.
Me.
Beautiful.
And we try to establish those things together.
And we're focusing on our fish philosophy of play.
Routine really helps children because they know what's happening and they know what they're going to do.
But we're still learning. So you're going to go to your groups and you're going to do your pick the pronoun, which is your print walk.
We run a literacy block, which is the same in every classroom throughout the school. So it doesn't matter what year they go to, they do the same thing.
The twos will stay on the mat.
And that consists of a print walk, which looks at environmental print, a shared reading, also guided reading, model writing each day, and spelling. The print walk was first developed in the Pilbara for Aboriginal students in remote communities.
Jewel, do you want to help him read those for me? Because you're a great reader.
I do that by game.
One of those are up on the board. So which one is it? So it is?
He.
Is that a pronoun?
Yes.
What works for Aboriginal students works for everyone.
You know that word, yes? So which one is it? Beautiful, well done, write it down.
I also have a clear signal to get students' attention.
Okay.
By them putting their hands on their heads, they don't want to fidget, they're not poking somebody else and they've got their eyes on me, so I know that I can give instructions and then they know what I'm talking about and they can follow through by that.
Another person to collect the print walk and one to pack up the game and sit on the mat. Oh, what's happening with the chairs there, Jewel?
I did a lot of activities and establishing what good writers look like, what good listeners look like. So when I first got them, we discussed what a good listener looks like and how they sit, and they practiced.
Yes,
we come up with whole body listening, is that when you sit on the mat, your eyes are open, your ears are turned on, your hands are in your lap and you're sitting up straight and listening.
How are we going to be good listeners?
You're focused on the talker.
Oh, you're showing me whole body listening. Well done. But you need to remember to put your hand up to tell everyone, OK? Grace.
Put your piece of paper that you wrote the story on in front of you, mm-hmm, and fold your arms so you can't place it.
And listen.
And it's a routine, so we go over it all the time so they know exactly what you're going to do.
The pink group's going to be on the mat sharing with me. Every other group is going to share at the table. So I should only be, how many voices should I hear at one time?
One. Three.
Four.
I also explain each step in depth.
So you're going to share it with the group, edit it, and then do your good copy. I write the instructions on the board so everyone knows what they have to do and in what order.
When I put children into groups, I do a leader.
I'm going to get Jewel to go first today. Is that okay, Joseph?
I'm second.
Somebody who usually has a better understanding of the task.
Show me how to hold the book.
So they can relay the instructions as well. So if I'm working with a group, I can concentrate on them instead of always giving instructions to students who sometimes forget. So the clear intentions are on the board, and if they are unable to read or understand that, there's somebody in their group who's in charge of giving them instructions and helping with what's going to happen next.
Beautiful. Yes.
Why might student involvement in setting class rules and routines be an effective classroom management strategy? How do you manage classroom activities and arrange transitions smoothly? What communication strategies do you use to ensure all students are able and ready to participate in classroom activities?